I've been interested in imaging techniques throughout my career. I feel like I'm really an anatomist at heart. I really love the structure of animals and the different structures of all different animals. And so really throughout my career, I've needed a technique like XROMM. For me, it's just the process of discovery. It's the process of seeing something that you can't otherwise see. The real innovation of XROMM is that the bone shape comes from a CT scan, and then the motion comes from the X-ray movies. And so it's the combination of those that produces this 3D animation that lets us see as though we had X-ray vision. And then with the combination of XROMM and fluoromicrometry, we can add the muscles to that animation so that we can really understand how bones and muscles interact to produce motion. The basic idea for the software for XROMM came from my colleague Steve Gatesy here at Brown. So he came up with the original idea of combining bone shape and motion into an animation. And then when I came to Brown a little bit later, he and I were able to together build this out to a real technology that we and other people can use on a bigger scale. One of the areas that we're using XROMM for now is studying feeding in fish. So when fish feed underwater, they have a fundamental problem. As they're coming up trying to grab a piece of food, they'll tend to push it away from themselves. And so they need to do suction feeding. So they come up and suck the food in. And this is a really fast and forceful motion, so it requires a lot of muscle power. And fish have muscles in their heads, but of course they also have all that musculature down the body that we really think of as swimming muscles. And with XROMM, what we've been able to show is that those body muscles are really the source of power. It's really changing the way we look at fish bodies altogether. We need to now look at them as a much more integrated system for both swimming and feeding. If we can understand some very basic relationships between the shape of bones and the way they move, we can begin to understand the species that we see on Earth today and all the amazing things that they do.